my D and place them both in mine. You know you stopped me dead while I was passing by, and now I beg to see you dance just one more time. Ooh.
First, you need to wash your hands. Then we have to get our ingredients. We need 250 grams of porridge oats. We need 125 grams of butter. We need 120 grams of light brown sugar.
Okay.
We need 2 to 3 tablespoons of golden syrup. It depends how gooey you want it. Now I need to mix. Now I'm going to add chocolate drops to mine.
There you go.
Heat the oven to 180 Celsius. You can ask your grown-up to do this because ovens are hot. Lightly grease a pan. We're going to push the mixture into the bottom of the pan with a bottom of a spoon. We have placed the flapjack in the oven and now we're just melting our chocolate topping. Be careful, the hob is hot. This is my flapjack out of the oven. Beware, it will be hot. I'm now going to decorate it with a drizzle of chocolate. There you have it, a tasty treat for when it's cooled down. Thank you for watching my video.
I'm a paleontologist and I'm going back in time to interview a T-Rex. So can you tell us what you enjoy to eat?
I'm a carnivore, so I eat meat. Other dinosaurs are tasty.
You look massive, so approximately, how big are you?
I'm about 12 metres long.
Why do you have little arms?
I don't know, it's a mystery. Are you making jokes about me? Any more questions? Because I'm bored. Actually, are you meat? Roar!
Mary Anning was a paleontologist and archaeologist. There were not many women doing this job at this time. I'm here with some of the fossils and plants we found in Devon. Mary opened a shop for people to see her stuff. Her family sold fossils too. Here's a dinosaur bone from millions of years ago. And this foot is from a velociraptor. Here is a foot she found in Devon's cliff. This is an egg with a skull in. Here is a big tea shop many years ago and she's still very famous.
First you get all the ingredients, which is a plate, some Skittles and some water. Then you put them in a pattern on the plate. You need to do it on a flat surface or it wouldn't work. Then you add in the water slowly into the middle of the plate. And then you wait to see what the Skittles make when the water sucks up the colour and moves it into around the plate. It would be starting to make a nice pattern with the Skittles, and it'll form a rainbow. Then you have a lovely pattern. And that's the Skittles experiment.
Did you know that dinosaurs walked the earth for 165 million years? They lived during the time that was known as Mesozoic era, or Age of Reptiles. At the end of the time, they became extinct. That was around 65 million years ago. All dinosaurs could swim, said Dave Galat, the creator of the Museum of Northern Ariza in Fraggrass. They might not have been graceful, but they could swim. Nevertheless, think of elephants or horses. They swim quite well, even though their bodies do not look like the bodies of swimmers at all. Oh, hi there again. So I'm going to tell you another fact. Most dinosaurs ate plants, just like most animals today, but some ate meat. We also guessed that some ate insects and fruit. The plant eaters ate ferns and herbs and leaves from trees, like other animals from our days now. Hello teachers and parents. So today I have some top 10 facts about dinosaurs. Dinosaurs lived in every continent on Earth. More than 700 different species have been discovered worldwide. The most fierce of dinosaurs was the Tyrannosaurus Rex. The bite of a T-Rex could easily crush through your bone and was 8 times more powerful than a lion's bite. I have another brainy fact about dinosaurs. The biggest brained dinosaur of all was the T-Rex. Since it's such a huge animal, its brain was about as big as ours, but it was many times bigger than us. Cytogorus was a tiny brained dinosaur compared to its size.
First you need the ingredients. Next brown the mince, and then then cut the onions up. After that, put the chips in a tray. Then grate the cheese until it's like this. Now you get an adult to drain the fat from the mince. You make sure the mince are cooked properly and then pour the sauce in. After, put half of the mince and onions into the tray so it looks like this. After a while, put the pasta sheets on so it looks like this. Soon after, you put on the white sauce until there's two layers. Finally, add some cheese until it looks like this. An adult puts it in the oven. Cooking in progress. Last but not least, lasagna and chips. Yummy! All gone.
Take my hands, my dear, and look me in my eyes. Just like a monkey, I've been dancing my whole life. But you just beg to see me dance just one more time. Ooh, I sink you, sink you, sink you every time. And oh my, I like your style. You make me wanna cry.
My nose does this, and I have pointy ears, and I'm more cuddly and soft. What am I?
I'm green and slimy. I like to hang out at the pond. I sit on lily pads and jump in the pond. What am I?
I have four legs, I have a tail, and I'm sometimes you hear me, and I'm a man's best friend. So what am I?
I'm going to be doing 10 push-ups.
One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, one more, 10.
So I've done my 10 push-ups.
Eloise, what are you making?
I'm making a maraca
out of beads and a Coke bottle.
I have a maraca and it's made of a plastic bottle and beads. And it's made of this.
This is for clean class and Mrs. Clark. First one, they have pink ears. Second one, they scratch. Last one, they're nice and cuddly. What am I?
Say, oh my God, I see the way you shine. Take your hand, my dear, and place them both in mine. You know you stopped me dead while I was passing by. One more time. Ooh, I sink you, sink you, sink you every time. And oh my, I like your style. You make me wanna cry. And now I beg to see you dance just one more time.
Move for me, move for me, move for me, hey. And when you're done,
The Elsewhere Emporium, Ross McKenzie. So far. My prediction. I think that someone has taken the Emporium. Now, since it's gone, Daniel and Ellie need to find it.
Famous experiment by Galileo to show that no matter what the weight of an object is, they fall at the same speed, so gravity pulls them with the same power. First, I'm testing a squishy versus a lemon. 3, 2, 1. Jack is testing the squishy and the bread. So Jack, 3, 2, 1. This time we are doing the lemon and the palm. So, 3, 2, 1. This time we are doing a chocolate Easter egg versus a lemon. 3, 2, 1. This time Jack is doing an egg versus piece of cardboard. 3, 2, 1, go! As you can see from the experiment, the weight of the object doesn't matter. So, the gravity is pulling down the heavy object and the light object at the same time.
A force is a push or pull on an object.
Force is a vector or a measure that has size or direction. If I push on the ground in the opposite direction that the scooter moves, that's the direction of force that I apply.
Friction is the resistance of motion when one object rubs against another. Resistance measures how well a material or object conducts electricity.
The friction between your shoes and the floor is quite non-linear. As you put your foot down, your shoe comes under elastic strain. As your foot moves forward, the friction holds the bottom in place. As your foot moves forward, the strain becomes too big and the friction between the floor and your shoe can't overcome it anymore.
Gravity applies a constant downward force on the tires of a roller coaster. The roller coaster tracks serve to channel the force. They control the way the roller coaster tires fall. If the tracks slope down, gravity pulls the front of the car towards the ground, so it accelerates. Gravity is a pulling force that works across space. The magnetic force in a magnet flows from the North Pole to the South Pole. If you try to push the South Poles together, they repel each other. And two North Poles also repel each other.
I've got a magnet and some little batteries. I'm gonna demonstrate how a magnet works. The magnetic attraction from the magnet picks up the batteries like this so that they stick onto the magnet.
The secret is buoyancy, or the ability of objects to float in water or air. Objects with tightly packed molecules are more dense than those where the molecules are spread out. Density plays a part in why some things float and some things sink. Objects that are more dense than water sink, and those less dense float. Hollow things often float too, as air is less dense than water.
This is my experiment on what sinks and what floats. First, we've got a fork and we've got some water. We're going to see if it floats or sinks. The fork sinks. Now we've got this empty Quavers packet. It floats.
I really like the squirrel monkeys because they're really cute, and how they literally like jumped on the sticks and ripped open the boxes. It looked like they was eating McDonald's, but then there was squirrel monkeys. These have to be my favourite because how cute they are, and especially the babies are really cute as well. I really like the meerkats because they are really intelligent, because they have a howl for when snakes come, because they run and defend the home, and a howl for when predators from the air come, and they go, and then they just go in their little underground homes. And I think really cute how they go in the homes, because I've watched it on a David Attenborough episode. I really like the Cooney pigs, because how they walk is really cute, and they are really chubby, which makes them 10 times more cute. And I really enjoyed them walking about. I really like the baby mongooses. Goose, because how I saw them like walking around sniffing the environment was like adorable. I could not tempt to go aww. Literally, I couldn't go aww because it was so cute and adorable. I rate the zoo videos 10 out of 10, because like they captured like the best moments, the cutest moments as well, and like the animal The animal's like very nice, especially the predator was really nice, but because it didn't run around me, and it was looking so adorable. My favourite part is when my favourite video is the first one with the squirrel monkeys, and it's the one with the mongoose as well, because I'll say they're the cutest ones.
This is the information that I found out. Meerkats actually have two distinct calls, one for when they get attacked from the sky, and another from when they get attacked by a snake. These have different reactions, one from when they hide underground into their burrows, and another where they all come out and then they defend their home. Ring-tailed coyotes are found in South America, high in the treetops, and they are very agile creatures, which means that they can jump to the very tops of the trees and they can hang by their ankles on a branch. And with ring-tailed coyotes, it's the girls that are in charge. Servals have extremely long legs, which means they can jump up to 6 feet above them or 6 feet straight ahead of them. This also means that they can run up to speeds of 20 miles per hour. And servals have the most cleanest kills in the animal kingdom. I really enjoyed watching the squirrel monkeys open the rainbow boxes because it looked like that they were eating McDonald's. It was really cute, and also when the babies cling onto the mother's back, it looks extremely cute. I really enjoyed watching the cooney pigs walk around. It made me feel really happy. I really enjoyed watching the mongoose lie around because it was really cute. This was my zoo report. Thank you for watching. I would rate the zoo videos 10 out of 10.
I bring